Morning. Hey, how about a quick look at some simple interest? All right, this is in your interest workbook. It's not a hand-in. It doesn't have a code on it. So let's jump straight to lesson two. Lesson one was too easy. There you go. So there's what lesson two looks like. Notice that we give you an example. We give you three examples of how to do it. So that's why I like the workbook. It actually shows you step by step how to do things. There's three examples: solving for the P, solving for the R, solving for the T. Right. So I would suggest you not do these all in one shot. If you binge on things, you don't really remember them as well. So, you know, do half one night and then a quarter the next night and then maybe another quarter a week later or something, right? And that's the best way to learn. Anyway, let's have a look at this stuff. You ready? So let's look at the first one. The first thing you do is you write down the formula. I think I've been saying this ever since all of grade 10. I've been saying this since September. Don't go writing down stupid numbers until you know what formula you're using. A lot of people just fling numbers down, and they're good numbers, but they're not in the right place in the formula. Now you can plug in the numbers. Write down the formula. Now you plug in the numbers. Listen to what I'm telling you, because if you don't do it this way, there's likelihood you will muck it up. Now what you do is you tidy up the numbers a little bit, all right? So you simplify things. So by simplify, I mean, well, 9 divided by 100 times 2, isn't that 0.18? So it's 18 hundredths is the proper way to say that, right? You don't say 0.18, that's 18 in the hundredths place. So you write down the formula, then you write in the numbers, then you tidy up any numbers and combine them and simplify them. Then you solve. Remember how to solve? Just pop that 0.18 under the 36, right? So if you divide both sides by the same amount, they're still equal, all right? And what happened was you got rid of the multiply by 0.18 because you divided by it, and anything divided by itself is 1. Now you know that 1p is worth 36 divided by 0.18. All right, get up your plastic brain. Well, you can do that one in your head, can't you? Right? $200. There you go. And don't forget, anytime you solve something, it's a good idea. In fact, it's almost mandatory to check it. So take your answer. You think your answer is 200. You plug it into the original equation, right? You're going to plug it in there. You're going to plug it in right there. And you're going to see if it gives you the 36 that you were expecting. And does it work out that all of that gives you 36? Yes. So you actually just checked your answer. You don't need an answer key. When you're solving things, you don't need an answer key. You take your answer and you plug it into the original expression and see if it gives you what you wanted. There you go. Let's try one more here. All right. So not to belabor the point. This is like grade 9 stuff. All right. So, all right. I equals PRT. You write down the formula. If the first thing you do is start writing down numbers, you're going to muck it up. This time the I is 16, the P is 100, the R is, we don't know what the R is, that's the thing we got to figure out. You still got to write it down, even though you don't know what it is. All right, remember that this is in dollars. The interest rate is a percentage per year, and that's in years. All right, so the units all work out. Units are important things. Now you tidy things up, right? You got 100 times a 2 here. When you multiply a bunch of stuff together, it doesn't matter what order you do it in, right? So if I've got 100 cows times 2, doesn't that mean I got 200 cows? Right. So now all you're going to do is get rid of this 200 that's multiplying the R. And some people like to say, oh, I'm just going to pop it underneath, right? Well, technically numbers don't pop around. So we're going to make both sides 200 times smaller. And if you do the same thing to both sides of a teeter-totter, they're still equal. Now you know what 1R is worth. So now you know 1R is worth 16 out of 200, which is obviously 8 out of 100. All right? Or if you don't know that, then you put it in your plastic brain. It'll tell you it's 0.08. And then, of course, you know, that's 0.01 is the proper way to say that. You're not supposed to say 0.08. That's an 8 in the hundredths place. So it's actually 0.08, which tells you that it's 8%. So the answer to this is 8%. Don't forget to check your answer. All right, take your 8 per 100, or your 8%, as they say in French, and plug it back into the original expression, 100. Here's the 8 per 100. Here's the 2. When you do that, does it give you the answer that you're expecting, a 16? Because if it does, then you know you have the right solution. Yes, it works. That you don't need an answer key. All right, there you go. One last one. Are you ready? And I hope you're actually doing these, right? If you're just watching me do them for you, well, then you're not learning. Try this one then. So here's another example. Now, do these on separate paper. You don't have enough room to do them all on the piece on the workbook. So you're going to want to be doing them on a separate piece of paper. And when you're done, ball it up and throw it away. You know, you just, all you did was you practiced. You don't have to keep it. I don't want you to hand it in. All right, so make sure you got some separate paper or enough room to do stuff, or maybe just do every second question or something, but you still got to follow the right steps. Don't take any shortcuts. The first 50 times you do these things, here we go, let's do number 2. I is PRT. You write down the formula. You write down the formula. Don't put any numbers in yet. Now, the I is, well, it says right there, the I, the interest, is 39. And it said the P, the principal amount that was borrowed, or that you loaned somebody, was 325. Oh, the R you don't know. And you know that the T is, well, the T's got to be how many years? And it was 1.5 years. So you wrote down the formula, then you plugged in the numbers. Now, let's tidy up these numbers. Let's simplify them, right? This times this is going to be, well, get up your plastic brain. 325 times 1.5 is 487.50 times the R. How do I get rid of that 487 that's mucking up my R? How do I undo that multiply? The opposite of multiplying is dividing. All right. If I make this side 487 times smaller, I better make this side 487 times smaller. All right, so now you know the answer is 39 divided by 487, what your plastic brain say, 0.8, and you know that's 8%. All right, so, oh, and it wasn't 0.8, was it? It was 0. Okay, I'm back. I had to fix that up. I did a little transcription error there. All right, so I had to fix that up. But don't forget, we calculated it was 0.08, which is 8%. And don't forget to do the check. 39. Is that equal to 325 times your 0.8 times 1.5? If all of this with your 0.08 works out to be 39, then you know you got it right. Give yourself a tick mark. All right, let's do the last one here. Question number 4. All right, you write down the formula. Don't go putting any stupid numbers in until you write down the formula. Otherwise, you'll be plugging the numbers into the wrong spot. All right, so the I is, well, that's what we don't know. We do know that the principal was $780. The rate of interest was 15% per year. And we know the time was 2 years. So there's nothing really to solve here. This is just plug and play. This is just evaluate. You plug in some numbers in your calculator and hit equals. All right, so when you put all that into a calculator, no solving involved, you just smash some numbers in, you get 234. But can you check that? Well, there is a way to check that. You could estimate. You could go, well, let's see me do it in my head. Well, I can't really do all of that in my head, but you know what? If I estimate, I'm going to check by estimating. Would you believe that 780 is pretty close to 800, right? So if you pretend 780 is 800, so we're just rounded up a bit, all right? So you're going to have 800 times 15 divided by 100 times 2, all right? And can you do that in your head? Look, 800 divided by 100 is 8, and 15 times 2 is 30, and 8 times 3 is 24, and times the 10 is 240. So if you just estimate by rounding some of these numbers, you say, well, if I rounded the numbers, I'd get 240. And then you go, oh, so 234 sounds reasonable. That looks about right. So, yeah, even when you do the plug-and-play evaluating, you can still kind of estimate. Sometimes it's better just to estimate ahead of time. All right, so there we go. There's the basic ideas of how to solve interest problems for simple interest. Wait till we do the compound interest. Woohoo, it'll get even funkier.